Chelsea were out to bounce back from that defeat to Manchester City in the Premier League. It had been three games without a win in England's top flight as well. Janusz Michalik joining me now to discuss their 1-0 victory over Fulham. So they did manage to bounce back, but boy, they had to work for it, Janusz.
Yes, I think Frank Lampard is going straight to church after this. My goodness. Lucky, lucky, lucky in a way. When I say lucky, just that they did get a result, because I can't imagine the tone we would have here and from the supporters. I suppose at the end of the day, they got the job done, but just, and it still looked confusing to me, probably to supporters, and most importantly, looked to me like the, you know, players themselves are confused. And I just wonder if they know where they stand, how they play, what formation and all that good stuff, because it made very little sense to me the last few weeks.
Well, does he know that? Does he know his best side, his best formation, do you think?
No, he doesn't. I mean, he's gotten a lot of players. We've talked about the fact that they're all talented. Many of them are alike. I think we saw that when they were buying all these players. And we've also seen him trying desperately to fit some of these players. Let's not forget their assets. And I think if you look at Frank Lampard, and many say, why is Timo Werner still playing? Why is Kai Havertz, even though they finally didn't start today? It's because they are assets. They spent a lot of money on them. And that includes Christian Pulisic, although that's not necessarily his buy. So in a way, you have to protect it. But you also have to be strong enough to know that you have to play players on merit. And I don't think we've seen that. In terms of formation, yes, 4-3-3 is his favorite. We've seen him play 4-2-3-1. We've seen him play 3-4-3. And you know, funnily enough, he stumbled upon it, although that one good decision he made during the game today was when he went to 4-4-2 towards the end. So, and that's, you know, when they scored the goal like that. So I'm not saying that that's one that you go forward but for a team that's so very good in wide areas, it may be something to think about.
And you can mention these big money signings, but the player who makes the difference is Mason Mount with his goal. But even before that goal, he was just proving to be so key to this Chelsea side.
Well, it's funny the way I looked at it, because, I mean, everything he's done has been extremely well. In this game, he was by far the best player. Him and Azpilicueta, of all people, I think, to me, were Chelsea's best players. I think, you know, his work ethic, his passing, his willingness to be creative was absolutely outstanding. It seems to me a lot of fans and pundits, you know, aren't warming up to him, right? The question's always been asked, why is he playing so much? He needs a break. Is he good enough? So I'll give it to Frank Lampard, because he has stuck by him. And at least he's the one player that's paying him back. Although, as I said, in that 4-3-3, because he roams so much and he's looking for the game everywhere, which is a positive, but that also can be a negative. So if you're going to have him play like that, why not play 4-2-3-1 where you play him as a number 10? But the answer to that would be, well, because you're trying to fit maybe Kai Havertz there, because he's got to play. Timo Werner hasn't scored. And again, short stint today. But, you know, I just think that players need clarity. Clarity in terms of how to play, where they stand within the team. Do they play on merit, Kay, right? Today I looked, and I, before I even said it, and of course, you know, we get our pompons out sometimes here on this side of the Atlantic about Christian Pulisic, and I know he's been injured, but were you not asking, like, why is Hudson-Odoi not playing the way he's played so far? If I'm him right now, I'm saying, what do I need to do to come in there, right? I mean, I'm on the phone with Bayern Munich every day. It's middle of January. And you know what? He came in and made a difference even on that goal, right? So if I, you know, I'm also thinking, well, I just think that in the end, there will never be a place for me, because they've paid so many millions of pounds for some of these players that ultimately will have to find a place in the lineup. So I worry about Frank Lampard, and I worry if he's going to make those tough decisions. I don't know if he's pressured to do that. I think, hey, the pressure is there anyway, right? When you pay that much money, you almost feel like you have to get them going.
As you mentioned, Hudson-Odoi making an immediate impact when he came on. Does that have to force Frank's hand to play him, to start him in the next game?
Sure. I mean, he needs a run of games. I mean, he's been scoring goals as of late. He's been good. And, you know, I think Frank and any manager will tell you, well, we'll get you integrated. But I think there are games like this one in particular against Fulham. You knew how you're going to play. You probably needed a little bit of a strength. I mean, he does have a lot of qualities that Pulisic and Hakim Ziyech have, but he's got that extra physicality, I guess maybe that first step or two, right? Because when you have Fulham, for the most part, have to sit after going a man down, you knew they're going to sit a little bit more. All it takes is that 1 yard or 2 yards, that explosiveness that, you know, Pulisic possesses and Ziyech too. But I think Hudson-Odoi was different. But I just think, forget what happened late. He deserved to be there from the opening whistle.
When you think about Timo Werner, obviously he came on and everybody will be talking about that miss where he put it wide very late on. What do you think this is down to? Is this a confidence issue with this player?
Yes, it is. As I said, lack of clarity when it doesn't go your way. There was a period of time where goals were falling. But again, this is when you watch, and if you go back and you could look at the lineups and results, it is constantly changing. And maybe that's why I feel that, you know, when you look at Chelsea, the way they play, I've mentioned in the wide areas, the one thing that they don't do is that they don't go through their strikers, their number nines. And even if Timo Werner plays there, but you know, if it's Tammy Abraham, if it's Olivier Giroud, they don't build through them. They just go wide and accept, you know, and expect that the ball's going to cross. They're going to finish it. But I think if you go through those players and they field the ball, bring others into the game, defenses collapse, and then you have even more room out there. So I think Timo Werner likes the ball early. I think Olivier Giroud would like to be involved in the buildup. I think Tammy Abraham would like to field the ball and not just wait for the obvious that, well, if the ball comes across, then maybe I have a chance to see the ball.
Is there anything that makes you doubt that Chelsea can make the top four, finish in a top four spot this season?
No, well, I still think they have enough talent. I think one question is Frank Lampard. I mean, at the end of the day, he's the leader. He's got so much talent, and it doesn't seem to me that he's set on the formation or best team. Some of it has to do with injuries, of course, blah, 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 all this stuff, COVID, and all of that. But I think, you know, when you get something that's good, you write it. And you can't look at the players, their names, how much they pay. And people will say, well, how do you know if he does that? Of course, I don't know. But it seems to me that way that some players are getting benefit of the doubt that's not based on merit and how the games I see, how well they play. So perhaps that's why we have these rumors about, you know, Thomas Tuchel or any other managers that Frank Lampard may be in trouble.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.